Hi everyone, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to start an Etsy shop for cheaper anyway. And then I'll go over all the fees that Etsy charges, and I'll add a couple examples at the end too. All right, let's get started. Now, back in May of 2024, Etsy started charging $15 to start a shop on Etsy. And they say they're charging some shops and not all, but everyone that I know of has run into this fee. So I do think they're starting to implement it across the board. Now, on top of that $15 fee, every time you want to add a new listing, it's going to cost you 20 cents. So if you want to start an Etsy shop and list, say, 40 items, here's what it'll cost you. The setup fee, which is $15, and 40 listings at 20 cents each, is $8. So your initial cost, if you list 40 items, is going to be $23. Now, unfortunately, I can't help you with that $15 setup fee, but what I can do is give you a referral link to get 40 free listings, and this will save you $8. So your initial startup fee would be $15. And actually, if you use my link, I also get 40 free listings. So it's kind of a win-win situation. Now that link for the 40 free listings will be in the description below. And by the way, you don't have to list all 40 items at once. You could do one now, you could do one a year from now, and you would still have those 38 free listings in your account to be used at any time you want. Now, if you close the shop down completely, you will lose the rest of your listings. But as long as the shop is open, those will be available for you to use at any time. They don't expire or anything like that. Now, why did they introduce this $15 fee a couple months ago? I don't really know the answer to that, but my guess is that they're trying to reduce the number of spammers on there and copyright violators who just keep opening new shops every time they get banned from Etsy. The problem with this is that entry fee, that $15, is going to make it too high for a lot of people in low-income countries. So let's say the rate of pay for someone in one of those lower income countries is $4 an hour. And let's say here in the US, your pay is $30 an hour. For you, it would only take 30 minutes to make that $15. But for them in that other country, it would be 3 hours and 45 minutes to make $15. So just imagine having to pay the equivalent of $112.50 to start an Etsy shop. That's 3 hours and 45 minutes for you who makes $30 an hour. So that's how it would feel for someone who only makes $4 an hour. Now, once you have your shop set up and your listings created, you're done with fees until someone buys one of your listings. When that happens, there are a lot of fees that are taken out of the sale price. Now, you're probably thinking, what the heck? This sounds like so many fees. And while you are correct that yes, it's a lot of fees, Etsy is still one of the cheapest e-commerce sites out there. Of course, you can set up your own website, but Etsy handles so much traffic. You get so much more traffic to your shop on Etsy. You would have to somehow create that traffic to get people to come to your website. So even though the fees have gotten pretty crazy, I still think Etsy is definitely worth it. I still sell on there, and it's one of my biggest streams of income. So let's go over those fees and a couple examples. Listing fee. As you know, there's that 20 cents you have to pay for each item listed for sale. Now, this fee is charged whether or not the item sells, and the listing expires after 4 months if the item doesn't sell. At that point, they're going to want another 20 cents to list it for another 4 months or until it sells. Now, if you're interested in how this works when it comes to multiple quantities on one listing, I actually have another video about that, and you'll be able to see that right up here at the top of your screen. Transaction fee. Etsy charges a 6.5% transaction fee on the sale price, and this includes the shipping costs that you set. Payment processing fee. This fee is 3% plus 25 cents per transaction. There's an auto renewal fee, and this is something if you choose to automatically renew your listings if they sell or expire. There's a 20 cent fee for that. It's actually pretty much the same as the listing fee. It's just another name for it, and you won't be charged twice, if that makes sense. There's also a multi-quantity fee, and that is also another name for the listing fee. It's an additional 20-cent fee for every item sold from a multi-quantity listing. So this is just the listing fee that you normally pay. It's not really an extra fee. Then there's the currency conversion fee, which is a 2.5% fee if the listing currency differs from your payment account currency. So if you're selling in US dollars, but let's say your payment account is in Canadian dollars, you have to pay this fee. Regulatory operating fee. Now this one is for sellers in certain countries. Those certain countries are subject to a small percentage fee due to operational costs. So in the UK, it's 0.25% and it's 0.4% in France. So it's pretty small. And then there are advertising fees too, if you decide you want to advertise your products on Etsy. I'm not going to go over those in this video because I have another video about those, and you can see that right up here at the top of your screen. And then there are shipping fees. These depend on the carrier and the specifics of the shipment. Etsy does offer discounted rates with major carriers like UPS and the United States Postal System. So it's usually best to just use the Etsy shipping labels since they're usually cheaper. Okay, so let's go over a couple examples, and these fees only exist if a product sells. First, we'll do a digital download example. Let's say we have some clip art, we have it listed at $2.75, and we sell it for $2.75. Now the listing fee you will have already paid. I just want to include it so you can see all the fees for this listing. So that one is 20 cents. Then you have the transaction fee, and that would be 6.5% on the $2.75. So that is 18 cents. Then you have the payment processing fee. This is from Etsy Payments. That one is 3% plus 25 cents, and that equals 33 cents when you multiply it out. So the total fees on this listing are 71 cents. So your profit for this would be $2.04. Now the fees are going to be exactly the same structure for a physical product, but you're going to want to remove how much shipping cost from your listing profit. So let's say you sell a physical product for $12.75. You've got your listing fee, which you've already paid, 20 cents. Then your transaction fee of 6.5% would be 83 cents. You've got an Etsy payments fee of 3% plus 25 cents, and that one is 63 cents. Then you have shipping costs for you to send to your customer. Let's say that's $4.55. So the total fees on this listing are going to be $6.21. If you subtract that from your $12.75, your profit would be $6.54. Now, Etsy likes you to offer free shipping to your customers. Don't quote me on this, but I think they will bump you up in the algorithm if you offer free shipping. So I do recommend that, but make sure that you incorporate it into the price of your item so that you'll be able to cover shipping without, you know, losing a lot of profit. All right, I hope this video has been helpful for you. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.